The deep ocean represents 96% of all habitable space on Earth, and it is teeming with awe-inspiring life. As our human influence extends ever deeper into the ocean, there is a growing need for effective and sustainable management to safeguard this remarkable environment for current and future generations. This can only be achieved if its management is informed by the best available science, information, and knowledge. The deep sea floor is biologically and geologically complex, encompassing a variety of diverse habitats from vast abyssal plains to flourishing seamounts and vibrant hydrothermal vents. Over millennia, the unique conditions of the deep sea floor have resulted in the formation of large mineral deposits of varied composition concentrated within these three ecosystems. The mining of these mineral resources has been hotly debated on the international stage since the industry was first proposed in the 1960s. And many issues remain today regarding the economic viability, social responsibility, and environmental sustainability of deep seabed mining. During this time, our understanding of the deep sea floor and the remarkable life it harbors has advanced dramatically. Parts of the ocean's vast abyssal plains are strewn with potato-sized polymetallic nodules containing metals such as manganese, copper, nickel, and cobalt. Once viewed as a homogeneous habitat, it is now clear that these dense pavements of metal pebbles are anything but plain, providing habitat that hosts unimaginable biodiversity, much of which remains undiscovered. Seamounts, some of which rival the greatest mountain ranges on land, typically feature a rock-hard crust that is rich in cobalt. Accessing these crusts would mean compromising the integrity of the rich, centuries-old biological communities of sponge forests and coral gardens that inhabit the summits and flanks of these underwater peaks. The towering chimneys of hydrothermal vents are formed by the deposition of minerals from superheated water jetting from the ocean's crust, as well as containing deposits including gold, copper, zinc, and rare earth metals. These vent structures support dense communities of animals that are not found anywhere else on the planet. Indeed, the latest scientific research provides definitive evidence that hydrothermal vents and their highly specialized fauna should be protected. The deep sea species that call these three ecosystem types and overlying waters home are often long-lived, slow-growing, highly specialized, or endemic, meaning they're restricted to a certain habitat. Consequently, deep sea mining in these areas is liable to result in environmental impacts, including habitat removal, species extinctions, loss of ecosystem functions, and alteration of species behavior and life history. Given this potential for the deep sea mining industry to indelibly alter these valuable seafloor ecosystems, the proactive development and implementation of comprehensive evidence-based management policies is paramount. The Deep Ocean Stewardship Initiative's Minerals Working Group provides independent expertise across a broad spectrum of scientific, environmental, and ecosystem-based management issues related to deep-sea mining, both within and beyond national jurisdiction. As an official observer at the International Seabed Authority, DOSI has over a decade's experience of working to ensure governance of deep sea mining is guided by the best available science and knowledge. In an age of widespread environmental vulnerability, the integrity and diversity of deep sea habitats must form a core consideration of deep sea mining policy and governance. If you work in marine science or governance and are interested in sharing your expertise to inform and support the implementation of effective and evidence-based management for deep sea mining, join us in the Deep Ocean Stewardship Initiative, advancing deep ocean science in policy.